Hey everybody, I wanted to make this quick video because I wanted to show you just how important a client newsletter list is. And the newsletter list is different to your blog. Okay, this is totally different to your blog. This is an email list I started doing only in December of last year. And basically, I send it out to all my best clients. So I've got 92 that I send it out to. I've had more clients than that, but I only want this, only want to keep in touch with the ones I really loved. And yeah, and it's not salesy. It's just very much like a hey, keeping top of mind, because not all my clients are on Facebook at all. Most of them find me through hows or referrals. So I just want to show you, just to give you an idea, get your juices flowing. And I'm going to tell you at the end why and how this has helped me immensely. The ROI on this, my return on investment, has been huge considering what I have to put into it. So this was basically the first one that I did in December. Okay, so it's just like a welcome. Just saying to people, I've had an exciting year with wonderful clients. Letting people know we're going to be out of the office, from certain times. And I've been invited to the Kibbis show, so just let people know. I could have really put in a few more pictures, to be honest. This was my first one. And then we just put happy holidays from our family to yours. And then I just let people know, new in 2017, we're going to be sending out a newsletter. Make sure you check, this is what's coming out next. Our year in review video is coming up. And then I just put this in. Obviously, we hope you enjoy seeing our updates. We love sharing with you, but if you have every time you don't want to, you're not benefiting, then please like unsubscribe. So it's always important to put that in, because honestly, if people aren't reading it, I mean, there's no point. Don't have people on your list if people aren't reading it. It's not really worth it. So, and then this kind of all got jumbled, but again, it's not always perfect. And I don't overthink these things that go out to past clients because they've already worked with me. They trust me. Put in some best of hows. So that was the first one that I did. Okay, second one, just to give you some ideas. This is Happy February. I even missed one. I blinked and I missed my second one. How terrible! We were so busy. So I'm just basically saying, here's a year in review video. Click here to watch the video. And the reason why I take them here, I click them out of that, is because I want them to go on my YouTube page. I want people to see, like, hey, I've got a YouTube page. So I purposely click them out on that one, but I normally don't. And then I just did a little tidbit here just to say, like, hey, look at, see this family room here? After I worked with clients for 2 years, they sold their home, and the realtor said that they sold it, within, I think, on the same day and for over the asking price. I can't remember. I'm not going to read all the details in that. But anyway, so that's just a little bit like, hey, don't forget, if you're looking at moving, or you're planning on moving, or you're staying put, contact me and I can help you. And then this is just a video for gray paint colors. So again, just showing your credibility, showing clients what you do, leading them to different places. And then this was the one for spring. Again, I was too wordy here, which is usually my problem. I should have put in a couple of photos, but really, I was just basically, these aren't salesy at all. So, like, really, like, for the most part, it's really just a check-in. Like, hey, click here to watch this video, and then you can see a video of this master bedroom that I did, that was featured on another channel. So clients can see that. Okay, then the next one, getting personal. So I'm saying, hey, happy Monday. And yeah, so hey, it's a milestone, right? So share things like, I'm celebrating my 6 years of business, or however long you've been in business, or hey, I was just featured in a magazine, or hey, we just finished, here is a project that we just did. And then I just put in, like, hey, there's a Mother's Day special, give her something special. That was obviously just letting them know, and just saying contact me here for the certificates. Okay, so this is June, ready for summer. Like, look, my fonts aren't even the same. It's terrible. I don't even know why that happens. It's so frustrating. But yeah, so basically, here's a picture of my outdoor spot. And hey, do you need some outdoor fabrics? Go here. It's not an affiliate link. Yeah, if I was all set up, that would be a smart move to do for sure. And here's a link on how to clean fabrics if you already have some outdoor furnishings. So I'm just giving them some value, not being salesy at all. And hey, by the way, here's something personal. We went on holiday to Mexico, had a great time, yada, yada, yada. And why don't you follow me on Facebook? I'm doing this, how much did that cost series on this week. Click here to follow me. So you get the idea. Okay, happy Canada Day. There's the cottage we went to. Again, not salesy at all. Nothing. I don't even know if I had a click through on that. Click here to see our latest blog post. Okay, yeah, I did. And then the latest blog post actually talks about a bunch of projects that we were working on. And I'll tell you how that was important after. Renderings to reality, that was my latest one, and I talk about Las Vegas. So I'm just showing clients, like, hey, this is the rendering, which most people have, 90% of my clients do rendering, so they know. And here's what it looked like at the end. Beautiful backdrop, accent, blah blah blah. It's almost like a mini blog post. Again, I probably say too much in it, but and then here I do say, hey, here's a call to action, contact me, because we get busy in the fall. And then I said, hey, by the way, I'm going to Las Vegas Market. You know, follow me here on Facebook and follow me here on my Instagram. I'm going to do one right now. So I just want to show you quickly. So now I'm going to do one that says, don't miss this online magazine. Your project may be in it. The email subject, again, when you're doing a blog post, I know it should be more like the five embarrassing ways that, you know, you can da 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 da, or, you know, it should be something that really grabs them. But again, these are my past clients, current clients. I don't feel like I have to be too salesy in getting them to click that button. And I do have a 50% open rate on this, and 49.5, 62%, 55%. I look back at them. And I can also see who clicked through the most. That's always interesting too. So, and then when you're doing the blog post, I always copy this and then I go into the next page. Just if you use MailChimp, you pick whichever template you want. I usually go to a campaign that I've already used and I'll just, you know, pick up that one. It's already got, you know, the format there. People like to see, you know, keep it consistent. Don't try to get too fancy with the formats. And then I'll just rewrite over this, and it should already actually be in there, the high feel. So if you put that in, it just sounds a little more personal. You know, people think like, hey, so I could just paste that, but it's already there. So I will rewrite this. And I'm going to talk about the Aspired magazine here. So I'll ask people to subscribe to the magazine, and I'll probably put this picture in it. This was a gym that was incorporated. And then this was a gym design that I did in that 3,000 square foot basement. And then I'll email my client directly. Actually, I just worked with her again. She just hired me back to do a mudroom. So just keeping in touch. And I just want to show you. So this, I'm keeping a log because I love to have my checklists and my logs. It's not overly pretty. It just is what it is. It sits in my folder. So basically, I just want to show you this. So this is basically the inquiries that I've had, or past clients and people who have booked. Okay. And this is all basically what I feel is from this newsletter that I sent out. So I had 10 people, 11, because I've just had a past client contact me last week. So I've had 11 people inquire, and of that, I've booked 7 of those people in, and I'm pretty sure I'm going to get Tim and Marie again. They're the ones who I did the master bedroom for. So this alone, just at $500 for my consultation times 7, is $3,500. And this woman went through for a design for the basement, and this woman went through for wallpaper, and these guys are going to do another project. So I think by the time I come, you know, to the end of August, you know, I will have probably made nearly $10,000 just based on these campaigns that I send to people. Okay, so this is really important. I think what we end up doing is a lot of times we end up working so hard to get new clients. And we don't need to work so hard to get new clients. If you've got a nice base of past clients, as long as you like them and you want to work with them again, you keep in touch with them. This to me is huge. So I know we work really hard on Facebook and Instagram and maybe YouTube and, you know, you're creating your blog, but honestly, just go back to clients who have hired you, who have trusted you. Just check in every now and again. I've got probably 12, 15 I could email, just going like, hey, how's your kitchen redesign? You know, are you loving it? Or hey, can you send me a photo? Because a lot of times we do the design and the concept, but I don't get to see it afterwards. This woman, Deb, she literally got my email where I linked back to a blog post, and I talked about a client's powder room. She emailed me directly from there and said, hey, Claire, I saw the client's powder room. We want to do our powder room too. You know, can I book a consultation? Absolutely. Of course you can. Anyway, so that is my tip. Okay. So work smarter, not harder. Go to your past clients, set up an email list, say to your clients, hey, this is what I'm doing, and then do it, and just do it once a month. And I think you're going to notice the difference. I can almost guarantee it. If you're keeping in touch and clients have enjoyed working with you, this is going to make a difference to your business. So hopefully that helps. If you have any questions, by all means, let me know. Thanks, guys.